most of the people are afraid of death because they think that in death they're going to lose everything. Another fear is due to the feeling that death is going to be very painful. All the fears are generated from darkness. And the real darkness is the darkness of ignorance. And that darkness of ignorance can be removed by the light of knowledge. So if we want to conquer the fear of death, then we have to have the proper understanding what death actually is, what happens when one dies. Now, all knowledge must generate from some authentic source. And here, our authentic source is the Vedic wisdom, especially the summary of the Vedic wisdom that comes in the form of Bhagavad Gita. In Bhagavad Gita, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is making us understand the difference between body and the soul, difference between the matter and the spirit soul. Matter by nature is inert. Every matter in reality is inert. Inert matter, dead matter. Every object, every material object is inert. Whereas our bodies, which is made of matter, is conscious. Our bodies are alive. What causes this body to be alive is the presence of the soul. The body, by nature, since it's made of matter, it's inert, it is dead. It's a dead body made of dead matter. But it's the presence of the soul, this body becomes alive. When the soul accepts a new body, we call it birth. But when the soul leaves the old body, we call it death. And the period between the birth and death, period where as long as the soul is in the body is alive. Now, in reality, this body is not the self. The body is actually the external covering of ourselves. Although the body changes from childhood to youth to old age, a five-year-old body changes completely into a 15-year-old young boy. Then the body changes into a 30-year-old man. Then the body changes into a 60-year-old man. So in spite of the change of the body, the person remains the same. And that person is the soul. When soul leaves the body made of dead matter becomes dead. And when we leave the body, anything that is in relation to the body, we have to leave behind. And that is why the fear, at the time of death, we feel that we are going to lose everything. Yes, everything in relation to the body we will lose, but we don't die. We continue. The soul continues to live. And the soul actually goes from one body to another body. It's called the transmigration of the soul. Our soul is transmigrating from one body to another body continuously, but that change is taking place in the same body. That's why we don't notice the change so apparently. But a time comes when we have to leave the body completely. But does everything stop at that time? No. Does everything end at that time? No. The soul continues. Now it is like a matter of changing the body, like changing an old body for the sake of getting a new body. Now if we consider that this body is like a dress, and when the dress is worn out, we change the dress and put on a new one. The body can be compared to a house. When the house becomes old and we leave the old house to get into a new house, we do not feel sad about that, or we do not feel afraid about that. Rather, we feel delighted with the prospect that we are going to get a new body. In a similar way, if there is a prospect of getting a new car instead of an old car, will we become morose about it, or upset about it, or afraid about it, or disappointed about it? No. So this body can be compared to a dress, the external covering of the soul. The body can be compared to a house where the soul is residing. The body can be compared to a car or a machine that the soul is using. So the changing of an old body is not the end. It is a changing into a new body. That's why one should not be afraid of death. Rather, one should be delighted with the prospect. The only problem is, in today's world, no one is imparting this knowledge. People are in ignorant because no one is giving people this knowledge, because they themselves do not have the knowledge. Therefore, those who have the knowledge must take up the responsibility to educate others, make them understand the difference between the matter and spirit, soul, the difference between the body and the soul. That is the first lesson that one should actually have. When somebody dies, we say that he left, he passed away. Now, who is the one who left, who passed away? The body is lying there, but we say he is gone or she is gone. Now, who is that he or she? We have to recognize that actual person is the soul, not the body. The body is only the external covering. And as long as the soul is in the body becomes conscious. Soul is so conscious that the soul makes the dead body conscious. And that soul is our real identity. And that knowledge, when we receive properly, then we overcome the fear of death. So with this light of knowledge, let's conquer the fear of death. So for the time being, I'm just ending the session. But if anybody has any question, feel free to ask. Please send your question to my email address, bcswami@gmail.com. Please feel free to ask any question that you may have pertaining to this topic, and I'll be happy to answer those questions. Thank you very much.